Handling crisis, I think one of the key things for that leader is to remember that moods are contagious, emotions are contagious, and a leader's followers will align their emotions and their mood with that leader over time, and sometimes very quickly. So you can imagine a leader who reacts in a pressure-filled, stressed-out way to crises, that eventually that's exactly how his or her people that they're lead will actually respond in the same way. They'll react in the same way. So that's the first thing I think in terms of a leader really leading in a crisis situation, is the leader has to have that emotional intelligence to realize their mood and their emotions are contagious and will catch on. We often call that the leader shadow. And I think it's really important in the notion of handling a crisis that the leader has to remember that they're casting a shadow and that their people really watch. And again, we'll take cues, even if the leader doesn't speak, they'll take cues from body language and all those things that are happening all the time. The second part of this is I think the leader really has to be agile and create an agile culture in the organization as well. I mean, things don't go right. Deadlines are missed, industry changes, market changes, competitors, you know, coming onto the radar screen. And an organization, and it starts from the leader, has to be able to act in an agile way to be able to, again, not respond reflexively, but to react thoughtfully, purposefully, and in a strategic way as they look to the future, and not just follow, you know, whatever wind of chance that crisis brings.